I had a viewer ask about getting waypoints to point at the point of interest, so we're going to do a quick tutorial on that. And I'm going to put a few waypoints around this central point, so we'll start out here. So now we have four waypoints out there. Notice that all of them are set at an altitude of 98 feet, and we're going to change some of those. So if we just select one of those waypoints, we have waypoint number one selected. We're going to change the altitude to, we'll go up to about 200 feet on this one. Okay, we have that one set at 200 feet. Notice the heading is at zero. Gimbal pitch mode is in interpolate right now. Eventually we'll change it to focus POI, and the gimbal pitch angle is at zero. Okay, let's go to the next waypoint. So we're at waypoint number two. We'll go back up to the altitude, and let's set this one down a little lower. So we'll go down to about 50 feet. Close enough. Heading is zero. We don't have it set to focus POI, so the gimbal pitch angle is at zero. Let's go to the next one. So we're at waypoint number three, and we're going to change the altitude on this. And we'll jump back up to about 150 feet. Okay, heading is zero. Gimbal pitch angle is zero. And let's go to the last one. And we're going to run this altitude up considerably. Well, we'll keep it under the FAA minimum, or maximum rather, which is 400 feet. Okay. So we have 392 feet set for the altitude. The heading right now is zero. And gimbal pitch interpolate, and the angle is zero. Okay, so let's close that. And we can see that on our map, or on our picture here, all of those altitudes are set to what we indicated for all those waypoints. Now what we want to do is put a point of interest here in the center of this roundabout. So we turn on point of interest mode, and we're going to put one right there. Okay, notice that all the aircraft now are pointing in that direction, but let's look and see what actually is in those waypoints. Okay. So if we go back up to altitude, it's still at 200 feet. Heading is 228, which is pointing toward that point. Our gimbal angle is still at 0 degrees, so it's not pointing at that point of interest. It's just pointing horizontally. And now what we want to do is change to focus POI and see how this gimbal pitch angle changes. So we're going to tap on that. And notice that our gimbal pitch angle now went to minus 56 degrees. That's because it's now pointing down to the point of interest, which is 3 feet from the ground. Let's go to the next waypoint. Turn on POI for that, focus POI. And notice now that its angle is minus 14 degrees. Now, why is it different than the other one? Well, it's different because the altitude at this one is 49 degrees, whereas on the other one it was considerably higher, 200 degrees. Okay. So let's go down to the next waypoint. Turn on focus POI for that. And that angle changes to minus 36 degrees. Now our next waypoint is considerably higher. It's almost at 400 feet, so let's jump to that one and turn on our POI focus. And notice that it goes to minus 69 degrees. Okay, now how is that going to be affected if we change the altitude of our POI for number one, and if we add another point of interest? Right now, all of these were at point of interest number one, since that's all we had. Okay, first we're going to change the altitude of our point of interest. So let's close this out, and let's click on that, and we're going to change that altitude. Notice that right now it's at 3 feet. Let's click on the plus sign a few times until we can get that altitude up somewhere around 50 feet. Okay, 52 is close enough, because we have one waypoint over here that's about 50 feet. So when we change the altitude of this point of interest, this should come back to close to zero. So let's take a look and see what happened to that waypoint. Notice that our angle is actually plus 1 degree now, because we have this at 49 feet and our point of interest is 52 feet, so it has to point up a little bit. How about our other ones? Let's move back to number one. It's at minus 48, so it's still pointing down, but it was pretty high altitude to begin with. So we'll step through these. We're at waypoint number two. It's at 1 degree. Number three is at minus 28 degrees and minus 66 degrees. Now what happens if we add another point of interest? So we're going to close this, and we're still in the point of interest entry mode. So let's put a point of interest over here on this building. Okay, so now we have point of interest 2 at 3 feet. Okay, what we're going to do is change the point of interest to which number 4 is pointing. Notice that we have two points of interest available now, and what we're going to do is select number 2. And then we'll close this box. And notice that this aircraft now at waypoint number 4 is pointing toward point of interest number 2. So to get any waypoint pointing at a point of interest, you simply have to turn on Focus POI. Focus POI, and choose the waypoint to which it's going to be pointing.